Hi everyone, in this video we will learn about sealed classes in Kotlin. So whenever we want to define a limited set of classes, we can use sealed classes. The most common example is when we fetch some data from a network. So a network call may lead to a success or a failure. So for these kind of situations, we can use sealed classes. And defining a sealed class is very easy. It is like an abstract class. So sealed class cannot be instantiated directly, but we will instantiate the other classes that are extending or inheriting our sealed class. Let's see with an example. So here I will create a sealed class. Let's say I have a sealed class data. Now I will represent the data in two formats, either success or failure. And we may have one more case, that is loading. So what I can do is I can create other classes to represent this state. For example, one state is success. So I have a data class success, and this class will give us the data. For example, the data is a string. I need to write a val here because inside data class, I cannot have values without val or var. Now to this class success, I can inherit the sealed class data. Now you can only inherit this sealed class data inside the classes that are available inside this main file only. So even if the class is outside the sealed class, let's say I have data class error and error is also a string. So I can inherit the sealed class data here because both these classes are in the same file. But if I try to extend or inherit this data sealed class into an other file, it will not work and it will give us a compilation error. And for now, I will put this data class inside my sealed data class. So inside my sealed data class, I have two data classes. One is success and another one is failure or error. And both these classes are inheriting the sealed class data. That means the success and this error is data. Now we can define one more thing here if required. Let's say we have an object loading. Now here the compiler knows all the possible conditions if you use this data class with a when statement. That means the compiler knows all the possible conditions that are success, error, and loading. And that is why you do not need an else branch, because all the possible cases are covered if you will use this thing with the when statement. So this is our data class and we have three options inside: success, error, and loading. And I will show you how you can use it. So let's create a function that will give us some data. So I have a function that will return the data, and here I will return data dot success, and I will just generate a random data. So what I can do is I can generate a random number. Let's say I have a random number between 100 to 1000, and I have random dot to string like this. So this function will give us a success data. Now we can use it here. Let's say I have data equals to get data. Now I can write this data inside my when statement, and here I can check if data is data.success. If it is data.error, and if it is loading. Like this. Now an else case is not required here because we have covered all the possible situations. And here we are getting an error because I forget to inherit the data class in my object. So now here we have covered all the possible cases, and that is why an else branch is not required. Now here I can simply print the data. So I will write println data. Now if I run this code, then I will see some output. As you can see, we are getting success and the value is 816, that is a random value. Now we can also pass error here. And in this case, it will come inside error block, and we will see error data, as you can see here. And the same way, it may return loading if the state is loading. So that is all for the sealed class, friends, and it is used to define a limited set of values. So if you have any question or confusion, you can leave your comments below. And thanks for watching.